am now the coordinator of technical programs for the TTFA. It means that my job is not really as an active coach unless I am standing in for a coach in one of the programs. But my job is to coordinate projects, the programs initiated by the technical director and the TTFA to get it up and running and to see if I can cut through the red tape and the bureaucracy. For instance, we need to get the women's program up and running, and we've started by appointing Carolina Morassi and, you know, seeing her get up and started. I would have, however, very little to do with the national men's senior team. I would be also focusing on the, instead of the men's senior team, the youth development program, the sponsored by NLCB, the elite development program, overseeing that being kickstarted and managed, and you know, coach education also, setting up courses and making sure that courses are run properly and throughout the length and breadth of the country for coach education, and helping to develop our coaches by providing opportunities, not just on courses, but enabling them to travel overseas and spend a month with clubs. We've spoken about these things in past administration, and now my job is to walk the talk.
Jamaal, what sort of staff you foresee having on board with you to assist? Because this is a massive undertaking and it cannot be done by you only. You may have the expertise to oversee something like this, but what kind of staff are we looking at? Because you're talking about an elite development program that covers the entire country.
And definitely it will take a lot of personnel well placed in coordinating the efforts. And so we're so thankful that NLCB has stepped forward as the sponsor of such a program, because we're talking about engaging people from in the zones, in the zonal associations, regionally across the country. And then when we finally get the elite pool, having the coaches that will be qualified. So we will need a staff. I'm still now working out these bits and pieces, but definitely we will need a large staff, mainly of coordinators and then coaches, because we want to train the coaches. We've already spoken to UEFA about setting up a course to teach coaches how to scout for talent. And then we're going to have a specific course for youth development, focusing on techniques in youth development in a more specialized way. So, you know, we also going to engage, there are a lot of minds in Trinidad and Tobago that have been underutilized in the football, and they have so much to offer based on their experience. The Cornell family comes up, people like Keith Lucloy, you know, people like Everett Galley Cummins, you know, there are so many people who have made their mark and can contribute that we can benefit from, and find some niche in there for them to be able to contribute. I think the sky is the limit. We also gonna consider the young and coming coaches. We have a lot of coaches coaching in the secondary schools, like Travis Mulrain and Jerry Moore. We've had Shirl and David, you know. So we also have the next generation of coaches who needs opportunity. You know, when you look at coaches like Novik Dinoon, Anthony Street, they've given human service, and we need to find somewhere in there that, you know, they as ex-players and now coaches could contribute to the development of our players. So in saying that, it could provide some employment opportunities as well.
What sort of role do you see for the individual Russell Atapi, in terms of, we recently saw him come back home taking up the mantle with the under-17 team? That team is now on a break in terms of no further qualification. What is going to be his role now in this program?
Well, one of the projects for me is to kickstart latter piece on the 17 team for it to become the next on the 20 team. And Russell is already, you know, initiating plans for it to start in January. There may be some players he may have missed when he just came into the into the program, but certainly he is now going to start the new under 20 team, which will be under 18 for 2017. And he will have 2 years with that team, so we'll have some longevity there. And it's making it a project. Also, the under 15 team, Russell Latapy is an icon. As a player, he stepped off the field now, and he's now into coaching. He's very qualified, you know, and he still can go out there and demonstrate and excite the kids, and show them how it's done. You know, so I think he has a major role to play in the youth development, and it also helps him with his future role to possibly take up the national senior team one day again. We know he was in the job before, and we certainly, you know, see his exploits now at youth level as a stepping stone for him. I think there's need going forward to have more stability in our coaching programs. We don't want to be hiring and firing coaches every month or every year. We want to learn from the bigger countries. And in order to do that, we've got to have projects that prepares for good succession planning, but also to help develop the coaches, again, not just from courses, but from practical experience.
In terms of part of your portfolio is going to be also technical advisor. Can you explain this also in terms of you're going to have various national women's team in training right now? You have the youth teams on the men's side as well. Explain to us your role as a technical advisor for the TTFA.
Okay, part of my responsibility is to advise people in the TTFA and also the people who have technical responsibility coaching the national teams. For instance, Carolina is coming to Trinidad as a very established coach in the world, but with little knowledge of Trinidad and Tobago. I've had, 18, 20 years experience in women's football, and I will be able to say to her some things. Don't go down that road, Carolina. There are some bad dogs on that road, you know. Of course, this is my duty to advise. It will be her prerogative to accept or reject. But I think it's a good feeling, because yesterday I was young boy, you know, and a player fighting to be a national player. I made it to U20 level, and then I became a coach. Now, today in the Caribbean, I am considered a senior coach. This happened so quickly, a few pounds ago. So now I am very, very, very happy to live this new life, to help other coaches and to advise and to open up opportunities. I know also about doors being closed to you, to be discriminated against, to be denied opportunity. And for me now, you know, it's an enthusiasm to want to open up opportunities for everyone. Also, you know, there's still a lot of disunity and division in the football in Trinidad and Tobago and in the Caribbean, especially after this whole FIFA scandal. You know, a lot of people feel that they were wrongly dealt with and stuff like that. I want to do my part, because football is a team game. And if we be coach, if we be administrator, if we be club owners, if we be officials, and we, understanding as a team game, cannot come together nationally and work everybody pulling in the same direction, then we've missed what football is about. So also, I see my job as a religious duty, you know, to my Lord, to help bring people together and let's try to build a nation, you know. I've given 10 years of my life in three stints to Guyana. I am now also Guyanese, as much as I'm Trinidadian, but same way I'm Grenadian, and because my mother was born there, and my grandfather was from Barbados. So I also want to see, not just for Trinidad and Tobago, but by us being able to achieve certain things and taking the thing back up so that the rest of the region could say, hey, look, let's go there, you know, because we also now want to aspire to be able to compete with the Mexicos and Costa Ricas and those teams, not just for the Senior World Cup, but at youth level, and we think in 2 to 3 years, the gap could be closed in a very considerable way.
Briefly, what is your take on the appointment of Coach St. Feet as head coach of our senior men's team today?
I think the appointment of Coach Feet is an interesting one. He is virtually unknown, but when I look at his resume and the countries he's worked in, he's certainly no stranger to difficult situations, and he's coming into a difficult situation. I've had a chat with him last night. He was traveling from 1 o'clock the morning, and he came straight to the Atobolan Stadium and watched 2 Pro League matches. This says a lot to me about his attitude to work. Some will be happy, some will be sad, and others will wish it was them. You know, this is the reality of football. For me, I think I will give him my total support, you know, and see how well he does. Ultimately, in this business, you know, coaches at the national senior level are judged by their results, you know, but I think it's important that he gets the support that is necessary, and we try to see how far we can go with this.
Also, on this note to the elite development program, there have been some talks in recent times in terms of this program already started. There was some uncertainty in terms of some of the sessions that people were talking about. Is it true that you can say that officially the program has not been started in terms of official screening sessions will now take place under your tenure going forward?
There have been a lot of rumors that the elite development program has been started. It has not been started. I didn't come to run around the program. I came to run the program so that, you know, when we start in a proper way. All these zones, everybody must know, it's not a secret. And the sponsors also must get maximum mileage because they've made a great input. You know, there's this song, this reggae song that says, nobody want to plant the corn, everybody want to raid the barn. And NLCB has demonstrated that they want to plant the corn. So we want everybody to know when this thing starts, because we want the butcher to send his son, the baker to send his son, the candlestick maker to send his son. We want everybody's sons and daughters, because it's for boys and girls. And, you know, we want to be able to make this a national thing. So it's not a secret. The program has not been started, and we intend to get things off in January. We're still at the planning stages. We will be going out here in December to engage the zones, the Super League people, the different entities, to get their input on what the program should be.
All right, Jamaal, always a pleasure. Is there anything else you want to touch on at this point in time? I think we've covered a lot.
I think so. Just to say finally that it's good to be home. I came home, you know, a conscious decision. I still had a contract in Guyana. I learned a lot from the experience, but I came home to make a difference in my community and in the country. You know, I think we're at a crucial stage. Football can play a serious role in youth development and national development and bringing our people together. And, you know, I want to commit myself to that. I'm saying that if it don't work, it didn't work because it's my fault. I intend to put every effort and to do my best with this opportunity granted to me.
Thanks a lot, Jamaal. It was a pleasure.